Hey, this is Papa from StreetFighterTradingSystem.com. All right, so for today's video, we are back for a frequently asked question. So the frequently asked question that we are going to cover today is actually people asking me, Papa, do you have some swing trading methodologies? Because I don't like scalping, it's too complicated. I don't have time to check every single second, the bars and so on, right? And another question that goes with it is I don't understand from which direction I should play. Okay, so I'm gonna show you today like how applying the concept that I thought you guys you could do also swing trading. Okay, so first things first. So first to guide you on where to start is you need to look at the video, so time chamber, when I'm talking about training, impulse retrace, okay? So on this video, okay, which is on the playlist, time chamber training lesson, I explain you that the market moves like in waves, and we can understand the structure of the market using the Dow theory, okay? So as a reminder, what is the Dow theory? The Dow theory says that basically, we can consider that we are in an uptrend, okay, if basically the wave is doing higher highs. Okay, so this high is higher than this one, this high is higher than this one, so we can consider that we are in an uptrend. Okay, but if, okay, so if we have the flip side, so we have this, okay, so we have this low lower than this one, we are in a downtrend. This one lower than this one, we are in a downtrend. Okay. One thing that you need to understand also is what people using pure price action see is that to understand if we are in an uptrend or starting a downtrend, is that they will check that if, okay, so this is the low, the retrace. If the impulse here breaks this one, then they will look at the first retrace and the second retrace, okay, to go short and flip side for long. Okay, so it's basically what we're gonna do to do swing trading. So first we're gonna see are we on an uptrend or on a downtrend. Second, we are going to look for a break of the previous to understand if we're in a downtrend or not. Third, we are going to look at the retrace, but the retrace, we should take it at a specific point. Okay, so the retrace that we are going to take is only if the Fibonacci level, right, reach 50%. So we will only play, okay, if the price goes at least at the 50%, we will place a buy stop, right, or a sell stop below the candle. And our stop loss will be above, so 1 point above the 61.8, and our target will be negative 23.6. Okay, so this is if we go short, and if we go long, well, it's flip side as I use. So you go from up to down. Okay, so let's say we were in a downtrend, right? So we were in a downtrend. Okay, so what you're waiting for is a break this high, so this high should break this one, and you're waiting for this retrace, okay? And you will take only the first two ones, and the retrace should retrace to the Fibonacci 50%, okay? And then you will place a buy stop, so at least the 50%. Of course, if it retraces to the 61.8, it's also good, but at least the 50%, and your stop, your risk, right, is 1 point below this 61.8, and your target is the negative 23. Okay, so now that we have the theory, let's try to apply it on real data chart, right? So let's take yesterday and let's take this morning on what's happening. So yesterday, we start counting, right? So we had this up move, right? So it starts at 8:30. 8:30, we start drawing the impulse retrace. So here there is a couple of retrace, so impulse retrace, right? So here first thing is this high, it doesn't break this one. Okay, so we cannot look for for retrace. Okay, this retrace here, we cannot take it to the long side because it hasn't broke this high, right? So we are still considered in a downtrend. This one breaks it, okay? But then you see, so it retrace, but when it retrace, where does it retrace? Okay, so let's check it out. Does it retrace to the 61.8? Fast to the 50. Okay, so I'm gonna zoom. Sorry, it's probably that you cannot see anything. So the price retrace further than the 50, but you see that it touched the 61.8. So here, for example, me, I would have placed, okay, on this candle, I would have placed a buy above this one, okay, and then I would have ride the stuff. So I'm telling you shit, right? So the impulse and the retrace, so it should be impulse here, retrace here. So it doesn't, it retraces more than the 61.8, so we cannot take this trade. Okay, so we continue. So we had the first one, the second one, right? So we continue our stuff. We cannot look at long anymore. So now what we're looking at is to have an impulse that breaks this one. So it's the case over here, it breaks, okay? And then we have a retrace. So now what we want to check is, does this retrace, okay, retrace to the 60, the 50%, right? So it does, right? So we have this thing. So impulse, retrace, it retrace to the 50. Okay, so what I will do is I will put I will sell over here, right? I'll wait for this candle, and if it breaks this one, I will go short, okay? And my stop loss will be 1 point above over here, right? 1 point above the 61.8, okay? And my target will be over here, right? So you can see that I would have got my target, which is my negative 2361, and I would have made like, let me how much? So around 10 points, right? I would have made around 10 points. Okay, so first trade that we would have taken. Then, so we look for another retrace. So impulse retrace. Does it retrace to the Fibonacci 50? No. Right, it doesn't touch, so we cannot take this one. And then after, it's too late. I will do another video where I will say where a party can restart, but let's consider that this party is over, right? And we cannot take short anymore. Okay, so now what we are looking at is trying to look at when, okay, we're gonna have the high that is here that is broken. So we have this here, it's not broken. We have this here. This breaks this previous high, right? So, one thing to note also that now that I see it is, as I said, so I remind this was the low that was broken, right? And we can see that this low, right, is acting, so it was support and now it's acting as resistance, right? So, this also is another confirmation that it is a very good trade to take to the short side because it has an impulse. It retrace at the exact same level of the support of previously. Okay. So then, so let's come back over here. So up, down, up. This, it breaks this previous high. Okay. So what I'm looking now is at this impulse for the price to retrace at least at the 50% Fibonacci. So here, it doesn't retrace to the 50%. Here, it retrace. Okay. So what I will do, same thing, I will place a buy over here above this candle. I will put my stop over here, right? 1 point below the 61.8. And then I will target the negative 23. And again, I would have got around 10 points, right? 20 points even. Okay. So we continue. So here you have one retrace, second retrace. So after we cannot look at a long anymore. Okay. So we continue the day again and again. So here it breaks. Okay, so here I'm I'm gonna draw it. If not, you guys are gonna say, ah, I don't understand how to draw your impulse retrace. So this is not, here we can already see that the power of the up move is losing steam, right? So it's doing a high, but the impulse is lower than this one, okay? So the impulse are starting to not get pretty good. Okay, so impulse, and then we have a retrace, and then this retrace is lower than this one. So what I will try to look at is, do we get, okay, a retrace to the 50, right? So we do. So here I would have placed a buy stop, a sell stop, sorry, over here, right? And then here we would have seen that our target would have not been filled. So it's one lost, but the lost is how much, right? So 11 and 13, so it's 2 points. So we won so far, so 20 points, 30 points, so 30 points, and we lost 2 points, okay? All right, so here, what we do again is we continue. So here it doesn't break, here it doesn't break. It retraces to the 50 and so on, right? So this is how you can do to basically have your trades. Now, what I will advise also, okay, is you can see over here, when the price start being messy like this and it's like flat, right? Your EMA is flat, like here, right? Here, your EMA basically was pretty flat, right? This is an advice that I can give, right? So it does up, down, up, this is going lower, then it does up. So here, it's pretty difficult to understand what's going to happen. So you should not trade on this zone, right? But you could have understood it, because when you look at this low, low is doing a low, a high, a new high, then it's doing a new low, then a new high. It's pretty complicated. What you want is to have a move that is easy, right? So impulse, that are really impulse, and on the downside, and impulse on the upside that are really impulse. And if you don't want to use the 50 SMA, don't use it, right? You can still use the market structure, and it's very important to understand this market structure. That's why my advice, because I only see 18 views, and this is a really important video. Take a look at the video for far, understand how to train yourself to draw impulse and retrace, because it's key to understand what is the market structure. And it will also make you understand which is the direction in which you should play, right? You don't want to swim right against the current, right? So if you're here and you're swing lower lows, but you want to go short, right? If you're swinging higher highs, you want to go long, right? Okay, why don't we try to look at what's happening now? Could we have taken some trade? So I don't know, let's check it out. So we have impulse retrace. So this is a little bit difficult to take a trade. Me, what I'm searching for now, okay, when I analyze, is to have a high that's gonna break the previous one. Okay, so this one breaks, okay? So now we are starting kind of an uptrend. I will look at the first retrace. Uptrend, I will look at the second retrace, and past the second retrace, I will don't look at it, right? But now the other condition is what? Can we take this trade or not? So to know, we draw the Fibonacci level, right? Does it retrace to the 50? Okay, so I zoom. So yes, so what we do is we place a buy over here, right? And we have our sell stop that is 1 point below the 61.8. Right, so if you do this, okay, you enter here at the beginning, your trade so goes up, it goes against you, right? We can see that it's going lower than this one, but never mind, because your buy stop is over here. So don't touch your profit and don't touch your target. So sorry, don't touch your stop loss and don't touch your target. You should always have a risk to reward that is pretty high, right? Like that, you can have a higher amount of loss, but your loss will be compensated by your win, okay? So as I said, go again on the videos where I'm talking about risk management. It is the most important video. You need to have a good risk to reward management if you want to do swing trading, okay? So in this case, it goes back, and then it reached our target of negative 23.3 31-26, right? So how many points would have had? Again, something like 20 points. Okay, so first trade, 20 points. Let's see the second retrace. Okay, so again, it retraced, and this time it retraced to the 61.8, and it's touching to the tick, right? So I place a buy stop over here, right? And then I put my stop loss 1 point below this bar, and then I wait for it to simply go to the negative 23.6. And up, we have it. And again, how many points do I have? 20 points. So I have 40 points with two trades. I can now go and rest because I made my target, right? So you see how easy it is, right? Number one is draw your impulse retrace. And as I said, to understand how to draw them, you need to train. It will not come in one day. The idea is to follow the Dow theory and the Elliott wave theory. Okay, and what you are looking at is retraces to the 50%. Why? Because those are the points where the algorithm are, right? So they are between the 50 and the 61.8. If it breaks the 61.8, this means that we don't have the right anchor point, right? So that's why I say our stop loss can be 1 point below the 61.8. Because if it breaks, that means that our setup is not good anymore, okay? So I hope that this video makes sense and that it will answer the question of people asking on how can I use what I'm teaching you to do swing trading. As you see, it's very easy to apply. Go on your chart, look at whatever you want. So I don't know, this was for, let's say, S&P. You can apply it also for... I don't know, Bitcoin or Ethereum or whatever you wish, right? Whatever you wish and you are playing with, you can apply this strategy. I always get the same question. Can we apply it on Forex? So let's check it out, actually. So EURUSD, okay. US dollars, okay. So for this, I will usually advise to take something like the 1 hour, but let's say we take the 15 minutes, okay? So what can we take? So it's pretty messy, huh? It's really, really messy. So we have, how can I draw the path? So we have an impulse, retrace, and so on, right? So on this one, for sure, it doesn't retrace to the 50%, right? So, oops, sorry. Where is my fib? Done. So up. Yeah, you see it retraced to the 26. So this, not good to take. Then this one, I think it does. Right? So over here, it retraced than more than 61.8. So you cannot take this. So it retraced to the 0.76. So where can I find the start of an up move? So why is this over here? Okay, so this one, for example, I can already see that it retraced to the 50%. Right, so here we have an impulse over here. Right. So impulse retrace to the 50. I put my sell stop one at the 61.8. So here you don't have points in Euro USD, right? So it's more maybe $1 below the 61.8, and then I want to target the negative 23. So I don't have it. So let me put it. So my target would have been over here and easy trade, right? Anyway, so I'm gonna cut the video over here, try to apply it in any market. This thing is not market specific. So this is the beginning on how you can start playing with the trend and taking some easy, right? Very, very easy trades using swing trading techniques. All right, this was Papa from StreetFighterTradingSystem.com.